One of the many tools that they have is Google Books. So assuming that you're already logged into your Google account, if we navigate to Google Books, which you can easily find it here under these icons, More, Google Books is there. We'll take it to the Google Books page. And here you'll see something called My Library. This is your own personal Google Books library. And there are Google bookshelves here. You can name them on anything you like. There's a red button here for making a new one. So we could call this research paper. Research paper. Create the bookshelf. So then when we hit refresh, there's a shelf there. More, called research paper. Now there isn't anything in it yet because we haven't added any books. So if we go back to the Google bookshelf and we put in educational technology, and we can do a search here of many, many books that are coming up on educational technology. So for example, here's one, Rethinking Education in the Age of Technology. I'm opening this book. I can have a look through, read some of the book here online. If I like it, if it's of interest to me, there's a button here called Add to My Library. And as soon as I move over this button, it brings up all the bookshelves. I can choose research paper, and this book is now added to my Google Books research paper shelf. And there it's here. The book is added there. Now, Google Scholar has something similar. When I'm on Google Scholar and I do a search for educational, and it'll bring up a whole load of research results here. So there's one here, it's got the PDF. I can click on this, have a look at it. It's a book, so it's automatically opening in Google Books. I could add it to my library the same way. But if it wasn't a book, so for example here, Thinking Towards a Constructivist Design Model, this is not a book. This is just a reference to an article. Then when I'm in my Google Books, they have the option here to save. I click it once and it's saving. I click it again and it takes me to my saved section of Google Scholar, and I can give it a label. I could either create a new label or I could put it under Educational Technology, which is a label that I've previously created. So then when I go to my library, I go to my educational technology shelf, we can see here is the one that I've just added, and there's one that I've added earlier on.